Hello, everyone. And today we are going to read this Albert Einstein story. It shows his story from birth to death. And I also made this book about it, I wrote all the special details in it. Okay, so this is continuing now. This is a compass, and this is Albert and Maya. Maya isn't really included in this story. This story's got Albert Einstein. His father gave him a compass. And when Albert Einstein was 5 years old, his father showed him a magnetic compass. Watching its flowing movement made him curious. What did it mean? Why did the compass needle stay still while his father turned its casing around and around? At the time, Einstein was too young to understand the answer, but he never forgot that feeling of wonder and mystery. Later, he wrote that watching the compass had taught him an important lesson, that something deeply hidden had to be behind things. The moral of the first chapter teaches us knowledge of what is does not open the door directly to what should be. Now I welcome you to chapter 2, which is A Talented Curious Boy. Albert Einstein was born on March 14, 1879, in the small town of Ulm, Germany. The next year, the family moved to the larger city of Munich. There, Albert's younger sister, Maya, was born. She would become his closest childhood friend. Einstein's family had a strong influence on his life. His mother, Pauline, played the piano. When Albert was 6, she encouraged him to take up the violin. Okay, so other family influences also shaped his future. Einstein's father and two of his uncles were electrical engineers. They introduced Einstein to math and science and taught him the basics of algebra by making it into a game. This is biology, math, science, algebra. The engineers. Okay. A family friend bought him science books. Einstein would pore over the books for hours at a time. He especially liked a book about geometry. Even as a child, Einstein had the ability to concentrate deeply. He would pursue complicated problems until he was satisfied that he considered every solution. Okay, now we're going to talk about this. In school, Einstein's talent for math and science was apparent immediately. But so was his individuality. He questioned the way his school's instructors taught him. German schools, like much of life in Germany at the time, were run with strict discipline. To young Einstein, the teachers seemed like army surgeons who only drilled their students to memorize information and lifeless facts. Einstein preferred thinking creatively. Creative word. So, when he was only 17 years old, Einstein was accepted at one of the finest scientific universities in Europe. Once again, Einstein's curiosity about how and why things worked led him to determine his own course. He often skipped routine lectures to spend more time in a laboratory developing his own ideas. Most of his university professors agreed that their brilliant youngster might have a very bright future if only he would do as he was told. Imagination is more important than knowledge. Teaching should be such that what is offered is received as well as a gift and not as a hard duty. The Patent Office is the third chapter. Surprisingly, Einstein had trouble finding a job after finishing school in 19... Chapter 3, The Patent Office. Surprisingly, Einstein had trouble finding a job after finishing school in the 1900 year. He had been a grad student. He had graduated from one of the finest universities in Europe. However, a strong sense of independence and curiosity had made him unpopular with the same teachers who could have helped him find work. A teaching position would have given him the freedom to pursue further study. While he felt the lack of one was a setback, he did not give up. He had ideas that he wanted to think through and test. He just needed to find the time and place to pursue them. Einstein found that time in 1902, which is the year he got a job. That year, he took a job in a patent office in Bern, in Switzerland. His usual job was to make sure that new devices submitted for patent certification worked the way there in winter, so they did. The job in the patent office allowed Einstein to do what he did best, pursue his curiosity and question established ideas. Okay. On his first day at work, Einstein's boss told him, "When you pick up an application, think that anything than Winter says is wrong." Okay. I'll do it here. I'll do this thing here. Paying plus the job equals freedom. Paying for the job equals freedom. The regular pay and working hours gave Einstein the freedom to work on his own ideas. In his spare time, he met with a group of friends who shared his curiosity about the scientific ideas of the day. They called themselves the Olympia Academy. Their enthusiastic group often met until late in the evening, talking and socializing in cafes or on Einstein's apartment. It was during those years of steady work and strong friendships that Einstein began to develop ideas that would change science forever. What we learned from this chapter is, or for another term, the moral is, I never think of the future. It comes soon enough. Okay, so we are in chapter 4, The Miracle Year. Or is it chapter 4? Chapter 4, The Miracle Year. By 1905, Einstein had worked in the patent office for 3 years. During that time, his curiosity thrived and he applied a great deal of thought to new scientific theories. He soon felt confident enough in his ideas to share them. Einstein signed papers explaining his ideas to the leading German scientific journal at the time. The journal published the first of these papers in March 1905, and 4 additional papers soon followed. Einstein's first paper explained his theory about the nature and behavior of light. The second and third papers proved the existence of tiny parts of matter called molecules and atoms, and described how they moved. The final 2 papers offered new explanations for understanding the relationships that existed among space-time objects in motion. Einstein's first paper explained his theory about nature and behavior of light. The second and third papers proved the existence of tiny parts of matter, molecules, and atoms, and described it. Oh, and these are the water molecules. Einstein proved the existence of molecules and atoms. It is now common knowledge that the water molecules contain 2 hydrogen atoms and 1 oxygen atom. A rising star. Chapter 5. Einstein continued to work at the patent office until 1909. That year, he finally got a full-time job at a university. Einstein took the job, but they jumped from school to school for the next 3 years while he searched for the best place to pursue his research. Why can't I say? Then in 1915, he made a discovery. He finally figured out how to unite his early ideas into a one system, which he called the General Theory of Relativity. From here. In 1919, British scientists tested Einstein's theory of relativity by measuring the position of a star during a solar eclipse. If Einstein's theory was correct, the star would appear to be in one position while it was actually in another. The star appeared almost exactly where Einstein said it would be. Newspapers around the world announced the findings. A British newspaper declared, "Revolution in science, new theory of the universe." Okay, so I think is chapter 6 or chapter 7, which is uses a frame. Einstein used his fame to draw attention to issues he cared about. One of Einstein's most deeply held beliefs was that war should be avoided if at all possible. In 1914, he was one of only three scientists who signed a letter opposing Germany's participation in World War I. More than 100 scientists had signed a letter in support of Germany entering the war. Okay, so many of Einstein's views changed over the course of his life. However, his strong belief in pacifism, the idea that violence and war are never the answer, remained consistent. Einstein also used his fame to speak about inequality. He spoke up in support of fair treatment for everyone. Coming to America. In addition to Einstein's vocal criticism of Nazi politics, his Jewish heritage came at risk. In 1933, he left Germany and took a job at the Institute for Advanced Study in Princeton, New Jersey, in the United States. In New Jersey, Einstein moved his family into a house close to his office. They soon became part of Princeton's close-knit community. When out of town visitors wanted to know where the great man lived, townspeople would ask, "Are you expected?" This question prevented strangers from bothering Einstein at home. From there, although he worked hard, he never achieved the sort of discoveries he had during the miracle year or with his general theory of relativity. Always in demand, he continued to give speeches, write articles, and meet regularly with fellow scientists. Einstein's curiosity led to the creation of many useful products. For example, Einstein's ideas about the nature and behavior of light led scientists to develop new ways to control light. These technologies led to television cameras, remote controls for home electronics, and flat-screen computers. Einstein was also the first person to think of laser light. This technology is now used in compact discs, CDs, digital video discs, DVDs, and store checkout equipment. His proof of the existence of atoms and molecules led to the creation or improvement of a wide range of everyday products. Those products include shaving cream, two-piece computers, and portable phones. Einstein's scientific ideas continue to influence new theories. Current ideas about the origins of the universe, space, and strange objects called black holes are all the results of Einstein's work. Oh, a life well lived, the last chapter. Einstein once said, "The most beautiful experience we can have is the mysterious. It is enough to try to understand a little of this mysteriousness." Until his death on April 18, 1955. Einstein's curiosity led him to work to understand nature's greatest mysteries. In doing so, he changed the way people think about time, space, energy, and matter, the foundations of the universe.